Have you noticed that there are two different methods for changing the time span of a trend? There's something called SetTimeRange, and there's also something called SetStartandEndtime. Now, the difference between the two of them is basically the same as the difference between editing a trend in run mode versus editing that same trend in build mode. See, when I scroll backwards using the tools in run mode in process book, or if I were to do something like view time range and then choose a specific time range, 7 days, ending right now, when I do that, that's something that is not permanent. It's just something I'm doing kind of ad hoc to look at my data. And if I revert my display, we go back to the normal time range, the saved time range. Now that's the equivalent of the set time range. If you were to use the set start and end time, it's the equivalent of going in here and actually making a permanent change in the definition of the trend. So see, now that's a permanent change. And if I were to start doing things like changing the time range here, yeah, now of course when I revert, we're reverting back to that new value that we did with the set start and end time. So set start and end time is the equivalent of editing the object itself.